Hello movie lovers, it's your boy Max again with another review of a movie we honestly did not need, but we ended up getting anyway. This is my thoughts on the movie To All the Boys, Always and Forever. So this movie is the third and last movie out of a trilogy. The first one was To All the Boys I've Loved, the second one was To All the Boys, P.S. I Still Love You. So if you haven't watched any of those movies, don't worry, I got you. So To All the Boys I've Loved before entails a boy who is in a fix and a girl who is in another fix and decide to date so as to solve their fixes. Wait, a wrong movie. And the second movie, To All the Boys I've Loved, P.S. I Love You, features a girl who is torn between two guys, one who is pale white and another a shade darker. Wait, wrong movie again. Well, seriously, you can't blame me. These movies all look the same. The second movie in the sequel is uniquely set based on Lara Jean's transition from high school to college. Honestly, to me, this movie is just a mashup of several montage sequences. What's a montage, you ask? So a montage is a film editing technique in which you use short shots, which you edit in sequence, mostly to save time and info. So if you don't want to show something that is done in a long period of time, you can just cut them into small pieces to show continuation. So the first montage is their family trip to Korea. The second montage is the class trip to New York. The third montage is the prom dance. And the fourth montage is Laura just baking cupcakes. The main message of this movie is that no girl should let their lives revolve around a relationship or a guy, especially a guy who smiles like this. So ladies, if you relate, make sure to leave a like on the video. In my view, I think this movie was made for a very young demographic in terms of age, like from 13 to 25 would make sense, because some of the things that happen in this movie would have been solved by a simple mature conversation. Probably we get a scene where Laura accidentally texts Peter a wrong message that was meant to go to her sister, but instead of just saying I didn't mean to text you that, sorry, it was meant for my sister and I didn't get into Stanford, they stretch it out to be a very big thing. There's even a point in where Peter comes to pick up Laura to go to their favorite joint, and then before she can tell him, he interrupts and says no, he save it for later, and then does one of the weirdest dances I've ever seen. And then the scene cuts to now they are at the diner, and I'm thinking, what happened between them moving from their house and to the diner? If it's a place where you have to drive, that means it's a bit of a distance. What were they talking about during that distance? That's where they would have discussed, and then she would have come out clean. But you know, shit had to happen for the movie to happen. I liked the character development of Peter in this movie, since we've shown more in depth about the daddy issues that he has. I think I related more to that since I have lost a dad and I know how it affects you. I would have loved to see more of this, but you know, the movie is not called To All the Dads I've Loved. So yeah, other than that, I think Hollywood will still be checking out movies like this. We have Kissing Booth 3, we have After 3, which is coming also soon. Both of them are coming out soon, and thank God this is the last one, because my God, that was something. So guys, thank you for the love you have shown in my very amateur videos. I love the comments, I love the likes that you leave on my WhatsApp. You guys encourage me a lot to continue doing this. So yeah, thanks for the love, thanks for the views, thanks for the likes, thanks for the comments. Yeah, you know, yeah, those are the things that keep us going. If there's any movie you would like to see, just give me a shout out, tell me which one you would want to review, and then the winner gets it.